Welcome guys, welcome to Inspiring Mind MBBS Abroad channel. So today we will talk about the in detail about the MBBS abroad, which countries you should choose, and we are basically focusing on the Ukraine. So today I will talk about all the Ukrainian universities and their fee structure and the eligibility criteria there, and also what are the documents required for the visa and the processing of your admission. So today we will talk about everything, okay? And also I will take your questions regarding MBBS abroad, jana chahiye ya nahi jana chahiye, kya problems hain, and why Inspiring Mind, okay? So let's wait for the few candidates to come live, then we will start the seminar, okay? So first of all, let me introduce Inspiring Mind. For the last 4 years, we are bringing students from India to Ukraine for MBBS. And basically, why did we start this? In 2017, when I graduated, I saw that most of the fellow students who studied with me, they don't pass the MCA exam. And then after me, Dr. Ashrey and Dr. Aish, we have discussed that the basic problem is nobody is studying when they go to abroad. They don't have any mentor to guide them. They don't know what to study, from where to study, because they are so busy in their personal life, and when they go abroad, they get a lot of independence, and they just forget their target, ki hum aaye kyun the. So at Inspiring Mind, we used to teach also, and also we have Inspiring Mind coaching center also. We are going to start the physical version also, but right now we are conducting test series, we are conducting quiz for the students, and moreover, daily dose of motivation is necessary, which we are doing at Inspiring Mind. So almost all the students who are studying under us, they are actively studying, and if we come to know that some of the students or some of them are not studying, and we used to call them to motivate them that you came to Ukraine for studying, okay? So just for this purpose we started. And so today we will discuss about the Ukrainian universities, which university you should choose and what is the fee structure of that particular university. So basically, total number of universities. See, I will take your doubts regarding the other universities and in other countries, but first of all we will focus on the Ukraine, okay? And basically we studied from the Ukraine, and we have most of great information regarding all the universities, and we are providing admission in all the universities. That's why we are focusing on the Ukraine. Regarding Russia, China, Georgia, we will discuss later in the question section, okay? So total number of universities in Ukraine are around 17 or 18, but out of them 16 are in the 15 or 16 are in the MCI list, okay? So total 17 or 18 are there. For example, Lugansk is not in the MCI list, Odessa is not in the MCI list, Donetsk is not in the MCI list, and other 15 or 16 are in the MCI list. So first of all, we will start from the center of the Ukraine, Kyiv. In Kyiv, there are three universities in Kyiv, okay? So total, guys, Kyiv is the capital of the Ukraine, and first of all, let me tell you a little bit about the Ukraine. That Ukraine is a country located in the Eastern Europe, and the border countries are Russia, Slovakia, Poland, and Hungary. So it's not a proper Western Europe, but it's in the eastern part of the continent-wise. It's in the Eastern Europe, but it's not in the Schengen yet. Okay. So Kyiv is the capital of the country Ukraine. So in Kiev, how many universities are there? Three. Okay. So which three universities are there in the Kiev? The first university, second and third. First is OO Bogomilets. So this is the like a national university of the Kiev, OO Bogomilets. This university is very famous among the Indian students. But we will discuss about the pros and cons later in the like webinar. But first of all, let me tell you, OO Bogomilets, the fee structure of Bogomilets as such, like tuition fee for Bogomilets is for the last year it was like $4,500. And it's almost same for the last 4 or 5 years. So we don't know about this year's session, like when will it start, because of the COVID-19 disease, you know, everything is getting late. So as soon as we get updation, we will notify you. Okay, so for the right being, we will take the last year fee. Tuition fee last year it was $4,500 for the Bogomilets, okay. And the second university in Kyiv is Taras Shevchenko. The tuition fee of Taras Shevchenko is $4,600. Right now we are discussing only the tuition fee. There are other charges also, as well as hostel for the airport pickup, miscellaneous charges, insurance, and letter TRC of the country and home registration. We will discuss that miscellaneous charges and hostel in the like in the coming section. For the time being, we are focusing only on the tuition fees. Okay. So Bogomilets has a fee structure of $4,500 and Taras Shevchenko has $4,600. And there is one more university in the Kyiv, that is Kyiv UAFM. So basically it's called as it's also known as Kyiv Medical University, because earlier it was University of Alternative and Folk Medicine, but after that they got the license for the allopathic medicine also. So we basically call it as a like Kyiv Medical University. Kyiv Medical University. So Kyiv Medical University, this is a private institution. Unlike Bogomilets and Taras Shevchenko, this is a private institution, and Bogomilets, Taras Shevchenko, they both are the national universities of the Ukraine, right? And also, if I talk about the Taras Shevchenko and Bogomilets, Bogomilets is a proper medical university, like only medical course is there. And whereas Taras Shevchenko is a national university and it has a faculty of medicine, but they started just 2-3 years back and they got a huge response among Indian students, like very famous among them, that the education is very good there. So when we talk about the like the university, there are three types. One is proper medical university, and one is the like a national university with a medical faculty, and one are the private institutions. Okay, also there are terms like national university, state university, but both of them have the fourth accreditation. So it doesn't matter whether the university is state or national unless it has a fourth accreditation. Okay. So Kyiv Medical University, it is a private institution with a fee structure of tuition fee $3,500. Okay. So total number of universities in Kyiv are 3, Bogomilets with tuition fee $4,500, Taras Shevchenko $4,600, Kyiv UFM $3,500, okay? If you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section, okay? Next come to the, Kyiv is the largest city in Ukraine, and after that we have a Kharkiv, okay? So in Kharkiv also there are 4 universities. Total number of universities are फोर. ओके सो फर्स्ट सेकंड थर्ड फोर्थ. द फर्स्ट इज द मेन नेशनल यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ द खार्किव विच इज खार्किव नेशनल मेडिकल यूनिवर्सिटी. खार्किव नेशनल मेडिकल यूनिवर्सिटी. ओके द नेक्स्ट इज वीएन करादिन. वीएन करादिन नेशनल मेडिकल यूनिवर्सिटी. The third is, the Kyiv UFM, which we have already discussed in the Kyiv. There is University Kyiv Medical University. It is a private institution. They have their second branch in the Kharkiv city as well. So we can write Kyiv University. Kharkiv branch, okay? Actually, some of the students prefer Kyiv city and some students prefer Kharkiv city. So that's why there is no hardly any difference between both of the branches. So you can choose any of the university according to your preference of the city. And Kharkiv branch started just 2 or 3 years back, and the Kyiv branch is already already in existence from the last 6 or 7 years. Okay, so Kyiv University Kharkiv branch, and there is one more university in the Kharkiv now, Kharkiv International. Kharkiv International Medical University. See, Kharkiv International Medical University is also a private institution, just recently started, and this year maybe this university will come in the MCI list, but for the time being it's not in the MCI. Okay. But this year, this university has a very high chances of coming in the MCI list, okay? But for the time being, it's not in the MCI list. And the fee structure for the other students, like the already the students are studying from other from other countries. So the fee structure is $4,000. And Kyiv University, Kharkiv branch, same fee structure, $3,500. VN Karazin, Kharkiv National University, the fee structure is $4,500. And Kharkiv National Medical University, this is $4,800. See, Kharkiv National Medical University, same like Bogomolets. This is the National Medical University of Kharkiv City. And VN Karazin is just same like Taras Shevchenko. And VN Karazin is a national university. And same like Taras Shevchenko, it has around 200 plus courses in this university. And it is one of the largest university of Ukraine. So, and also it has a medical faculty. And I myself studied from the VN Karazin only, okay? So $4,500 fee structure. So next, actually I am writing all the universities so that there won't be any a problem in choosing the university for you guys. You can choose according to your city, you can choose according to the fee structure, or you can choose according to the rank of the university. Actually, frankly speaking, rank doesn't matter. You can if you want to know the each and every department, you can personally write me which department is good in the Kharkiv city and which department is good in the Kyiv city and which department is good in the Vinnytsia, Lviv. You can text me personally. But if you go according to the ranking, I would say that that is biased, because ranking is based on many factors and you are particularly focusing on the medical education. So if you want to know about the departments, you can personally write us, or in the comment section you can write. I will try to answer there, okay? So next, after Kyiv and Kharkiv, we will talk about the Vinnytsia. In Vinnytsia, there is University, National Pirogov Memorial Medical University, okay? Commonly known as Vinnytsia National Medical University. Vinnytsia has a fee structure of $5,000. See, Vinnytsia has the highest fee structure in Ukraine, and You can say that so is education is the best in the Ukraine. In Lviv, there is a university, Lviv National Medical University, or Danilevskoe Lviv National Medical University. Guys, if you have any doubt or query, you can write in the comment section, okay? Lviv National Medical University. Lviv has a fee structure of $4,900. Okay? And after Vinnytsia, Lviv, then next is the Ivano-Frankivsk. In Ivano-Frankivsk, there is the University of Ivano-Frankivsk National Medical University. It has a fee structure of $4,000. It is also a proper national medical university and with a very low fee structure. So you can also think about the Ivano, and we will also discuss about the other universities which are good and low budget universities. Okay. So after Ivano, the same fee structure university is Poltava. In Poltava, there is university Poltava State Medical University, or also known as Ukrainian Stomatological Academy, Poltava State Medical University. It has a fee structure of $4,000 for the first 3 years, and after that, from third year, it is $4,800. Clinical subjects are very good in Poltava, so that's why they are taking $4,800 from fourth year onward, okay, from third year onward. Fourth, fifth, sixth year, $4,800, and first 3 years, $4,000, okay? Actually, why I am discussing this fee structure, because most of the students, when talk to the consultants, everyone will tell them the different fee structure. So this is the real fee structure according to the 2019, and this year most probably 90% will remain the same, okay? And also whenever you choose your university, it doesn't matter to which consultant you the main thing is satisfaction. Whatever consultancy you choose, you just need to get satisfaction that you are 100% satisfied with the university, with the consultancy. They are properly guiding you, they are discussing each and every aspect of the university, they are not hiding anything from you. So last year many consultancies charge extra on the name of fee structure. So remember one thing, actually if we talk about the abroad MBBS, there is hardly any chance of fraud, because I haven't seen much cases of the fraud. Just about the someone applying to the Vinnytsia and they get the invitation from the other university, someone is applying for the Lviv and they get invitation from the other university. This is the type of the fraud I have already seen. And one thing, sometimes what happened, the consultant or the contractors in Ukraine, they take the fee by cash. And they don't even give you the receipt back for the fee you deposited. So then it will create a problem. Sometimes what happens, they forget that whether you have paid the fee or not. So I will suggest you, either you can pay the fee in the university account directly, or you can come bring the cash with you and you can deposit on your own in the bank. Okay, so these two are the best variant. Either you yourself deposit the fee in the bank, or you transfer the fee from the India only. Okay, and this is the official fee structure of all the universities what I am discussing right now. Okay, so $4,000 for the first 3 years. And $4,800 for 4th, 5th and 6th year, Poltava State Medical University. Then comes the Uzhgorod. Uzhgorod National Medical University. It is also a wonderful university, like it has very high MCA passing rate, same like Lviv and Vinnytsia. And also it is a very low budget university, $3,800 fee structure only. And whatever the fee structure we are discussing, this is a constant, okay? Once you sign the contract with this fee structure, there won't be any increment every year, okay? Only exception is the Poltava and Tarnopil, we will discuss later. See, Uzhgorod National Medical University with a fee structure of $3,800. Then the next is Tarnopil. Tarnopil has Tarnopil National Medical University. Till 2018, it has the tag of State Medical University, but in 2019, Tarnopil got the national tag, Tarnopil National Medical University now. See, the starting fee structure for the Tarnopil is $3,800, and after that, each year they are increasing the fee by $200 to $250. So next year would be $4,000, then $4,100, then $4,400, then $4,500. So in this way, they are increasing the fee structure. Okay, but the starting first year fee is $3,800. Okay. So right now we have discussed we have already National Medical University and in Vinnytsia we Inspiring Mind, we have around 300 plus students already studying here, okay. Guys, it has a highest fee structure all over Ukraine, but personally I really like this university, that's why most of our students are studying in this university only. In other universities we have 5 or 10 students in each and every university, but here we have 300 plus students in the Vinnytsia National Medical University. They are already studying in the first year, second year, third year, fourth year. After that, we discuss the Lviv National Medical University with a fee structure of $4,900, then Ivano $4,000, Poltava $4,000 for the first 3 years, and after that $4,800 for the fourth, fifth and sixth year. And after that, we discuss the Uzhgorod National Medical University, then Tarnopil National Medical University, and let me check how many universities are left. So we have discussed almost all the universities, only two universities are left. One is in the Sumy state and one is Bukovinian, Chernivtsi, I think, Bukovinian. Sumy is also a state medical university. Sumy is very famous in the southern India, but in the northern side hardly any student I have seen which are they are going there. So Sumy has a fee structure of $4,300, and Bukovina is also a state medical university with a fee structure of $3,800. So they are also in the budget. And one more, Zaporozhye. It is also a state medical university. With a fee structure of $4,000. Okay, so we have almost covered all the universities. Now let's discuss about the criteria for the admission in Ukraine, okay? See, basically you need four things to be eligible for studying MBBS in Ukraine. The first is, you must have done plus two from like CBSE board or state board, not from the private, okay? Twelfth medical with 50% passing minimum and 50% minimum in PCB. See, some universities prefer 50% minimum in PCB, like most of the universities prefer 50% minimum in PCB, but there are universities like Lviv and Vinnytsia, they prefer minimum 50% in each subject of PCB. Like for example, if you have got 50% overall in PCB, like you got more marks in biology and chemistry but less marks in the physics, like 49% or 48%. But if you want to get admission in Lviv or Vinnytsia, then you need minimum 50% in each individual subject, physics, chemistry and bio, okay? So 50% minimum in PCB, okay? And after that, NEET must be qualified. This year we don't know the cutoff for the MBBS abroad, but last year it was like 135 something for the general category. So NEET must be qualified. The third thing is, see, you must have a passport with a minimum validity of 1 year. And also one important factor which I left, you must be 17 year age or above, okay? Well, I know many students who came to Ukraine at the age of 16 and after studying for 3 or 4 years, they came to know that they were not eligible to study, and some of the like agents in the India and contractors, they did fraud with them, and now they are regretting like what to do. They won't be eligible to write the MCA exam later in life because they came to Ukraine at the age of 16. So minimum you must be 17 years age or above. And 12th medical with 50% minimum marks. Even I have seen students who came to Ukraine with a 45 or 48%, and somehow by like by hook and crook, the agent got them the like admission, and now they are regretting. Like when they came to Ukraine, they don't even know that they didn't have minimum 50% marks. Okay, so make sure you have a 50% passing marks and 50% minimum in PCB, and NEET must be qualified, passport with a minimum validity of 1 year, and age must be 17 years and above. And also there are many documents which are required for the visa. Documents requirement. See, I am writing, why I am sharing documents, because if you are planning for the MBBS abroad, you must like start making documents right now only, because it will take around 2 to 3 months for the passport, and you need also birth certificate and other documents, okay? See, you need 10th, 11th, 12th passing and
मार्कशीट, सर्टिफिकेट, नीट रिजल्ट, बर्थ सर्टिफिकेट, देन मेडिकल सर्टिफिकेट दैट आई विल शेयर द फॉर्मेट विद यू दोज हू आर इंटरेस्टेड. लाइक यू नीड अ एच आई वी टेस्ट ऑल्सो विद द मेडिकल सर्टिफिकेट यू नीड टू अटैच द रिपोर्ट्स एज वेल. यू नीड अ लाइक कंप्लीट सी बी सी एंड लाइक कंप्लीट ब्लड अकाउंट एंड आफ्टर दैट एच आई वी टेस्ट अलीसा एंड आफ्टर दैट फिजिकल रिपोर्ट ओके फिजिकल फिटनेस सर्टिफिकेट ऑल्सो with the medical report and it must be signed by the MO medical officer or any other official doctor okay medical certificate that we will have. You don't need to worry about that we will help in the when you will apply for the admission we will try to make on our own okay medical certificate and after that birth certificate medical certificate NEET result and translation that we will do on our own translation in Ukrainian language. So everything must be translated in Ukrainian language before applying for the visa. And also you need affidavit for the sponsorship. Like your parents are sponsoring you, so you need affidavit for that, okay? And minimum bank balance. Of 4.5 lakh statement and 6 months back okay 4.5 lakhs or if it's in the if it's in the student's account then 3.5 lakhs okay and also you need 4 passport size photos with the affidavit for the sponsorship you also need ID proof of your parent and the 9th passport in original okay passport in original. So these are the document you need minimum for the admission process and once you are ready for the admission we will apply for the admission letter and the admission letter is a document which like confirms your admission in the university but it's like it's different from the invitation letter. Invitation letter is when the university is inviting you. So this invitation letter is particularly for the embassy, okay? It's not for you, it's for the embassy so that they can approve your visa and after that you need to submit the invitation letter in the university itself, okay? So admission letter is that they are confirming your admission and after that invitation letter is for the visa that embassy should approve your visa and after that you need to submit back in the university and once you get the admission letter, invitation letter in original from the university, that we will try to get from the university by courier okay so admission letter invitation letter after that we will apply with these documents for the visa and as soon as you get the visa then we will discuss about the funds transfer bank transfer and if you need a forex card or something related to the packaging what you need to bring with you to Ukraine and after that we will book the air tickets. And this is the starting procedure for the admission, okay? And as soon as you land, and then there will be airport pickup by the university officials. And after that, they start the procedure again. Again you will have to undergo medical checks and medical checkups, and then medical insurance, and then we will apply for the temporary permanent temporary residency in Ukraine, and home registration. And you will also see. In Ukraine, every university has its own entrance test. Okay, when you come to Ukraine in the starting first or second day, you have to pass the entrance exam. Okay,
So every university in Ukraine has its own entrance test. Okay. क्या क्या आता है एंट्रेंस टेस्ट में? यू विल गेट क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू बायोलॉजी, केमिस्ट्री, फिजिक्स एंड इंग्लिश ग्रामर एंड ऑल्सो प्लस ओरल इंटरव्यू. एंड गाइस हियर for example, if you have a gap from plus two, like if you are applying this year in 2020 for the admission and you pass your 12th right 4 or 3 or 4 years back, then also you need to provide the gap certificate. Okay. It may be anything, like you are like wherever you were taking the coaching classes, you can provide the admit card or anything from the coaching institute in Britain that you were preparing for the exam. So anything, but you have to provide the gap certificate also. Okay. So every university in Ukraine has its own entrance test and plus oral interview is also there. So biology, chemistry, physics, English grammar plus oral interview, then only you will get the admission. Actually the passing rate is very high, like most of the students I hardly like saw in my life that that any student got failed and they like deport him back. But so most of the students pass this exam. So let's discuss little bit about the Ukraine system of education. So basically here we have a 6 years of MBBS course. Okay. So in Ukraine, and here we follow European credit transfer system. So each and every class has its own hours that you have to fulfill. Okay, you can't skip any class. Okay, if you, for example, if you skip any class, you have to rework that class. Okay, like you have to appear for the class again on the weekends or any other day. Okay, so European credit transfer system. And also guys, there is no university in Ukraine which has a bilingual mode of teaching. Okay, like in Russia, in China, you must have heard that there is bilingual system. For the first 3 years they teach in English and after that they teach in Russian, or sometimes they start from the Russian only. They will provide you the like language course for 1 year and after that they will start the medical in Russian language. But in Ukraine there is no university which which has a bilingual mode. So all universities are teaching in English medium only. There is no bilingual university. Actually not bilingual, they have a like Ukrainian language in Russian language, but that's for their own students. Okay, but for the foreigners it's in only in English. Okay. So mode of teaching, only in English. Also, see, unlike Georgia, China, Russia, you have to appear for the two screening exam also in Ukraine. See, the first screening exam is after third year. There are two screening exams, CROC 1 and CROC 2. CROC 1 is after third year. See, if you want to go to fourth year, you must have passed CROC 1. And there are three chances, okay? Three attempts. And the passing percentage is 60%. In CROC 2, there is only one attempt.
Clock 2 is after the 6th year, okay? In Clock 2, you will get the questions related to the clinical medicine only, okay? Like of gyne, pediatrics, internal medicine, surgery. But in Clock 1, you will get questions related to anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, or like the basic science, okay? So there is only one attempt for the Clock 2, and passing percentage is same, 60%. See guys, this is very simple exam. In Clock 1, I got 75% and in Clock 2, I got the 93%. So you can see, like, I think hardly I have seen students who are failing this exam. Like, out of 100, 1 or 2 will fail the exam who don't ever, like, touch the book, okay? So, don't get trapped in the rumors like ki Ukraine mein Clock 1, Clock 2 bahut tough hai, pass nahi hote, aap screening exam nahi pass kar paoge to fourth year mein nahi jaoge. See, at the end of your medical degree, after graduation from Ukraine, you have to appear for the MCA screening exam, like, which is 100 times more tougher than the Clock 1 and Clock 2 exam, okay? So basically, with the help of Clock 1 and Clock 2, you are getting prepared for the MCA screening exam, right? So I think if you are like if you are afraid of the Clock 1 and Clock 2 exam and you are choosing Armenia, Georgia, Russia, China over Ukraine, that it's a big mistake. Because when you will write the MCA exam, you will see that most of the students from Ukraine, they have a better percentage as compared to the other universities, like other countries. Why? Because they have already appeared for the screening exam, Clock 1, Clock 2. So this is a 200 questions paper. 200 questions, here also 200 questions, okay? So I think we have discussed everything about the universities, and in Ukraine, the mode of education is like the English, duration is 6 years, European credit transfer system. There are two screening exams, one is after 3rd year and the second is after 6th year. Three attempts are there. Three attempts are there in the Clock 1, and in Clock 2 there is only one attempt. Passing percentage is 60% in the Clock 1 and same in the Clock 2, and the paper consists of 200 questions, okay? So entrance test dena padta hai, oral interview hota hai admission ke time pe, documents kya kya aapko ready karne hai admission ke liye. Also criteria, you must fulfill the criteria like 12th medical with 50% minimum in PCB, and NEET must be qualified, passport with a minimum validity of 1 year, age must be 17 years or above, make sure, okay? So universities we have discussed, there are like ABCDEFGHIJK, like there are around 15 to 16 universities. The Ferozia State Medical University is there, Bukovina State Medical University, Sumy State Medical University, Ternopil National Medical University, Uzhgorod National Medical, Poltava State, Ivano-Frankivsk National, Lviv National, and Vinnytsia National Medical University. There are 4 universities in Kharkiv we have discussed, and in Kyiv 3 universities, okay? So you can ask me any doubt if you have regarding like MBBS abroad in Ukraine. I will try to answer each and everything. Okay guys, so this is about MBBS abroad in Ukraine. If you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. And about the other charges like miscellaneous charges, hostel, they are different for each and every university, because some universities take insurance for the 6 years, some universities take insurance for the 1st year itself, and every year you have to renew it. And hostels are depending on the remount, like renovation. Some are costly, like $1,000, $1,500, and some are cheaper, around $500, $700. So you can to know about the miscellaneous charges, hostel charges, and the service charges, you can write us like in the comment section below, or you can WhatsApp us, at the given number below, or you can also write us an email, okay? Okay, thank you so much.